Greetings, gentlemen. PomPa here. So, I'm starting portal now. So, last time, what we did was... we managed to beat all the Half-Life 2 games. And now we're on to Portal, the next Valve game on the list. And after that, it's obviously Portal 2, which I also plan on doing the co-op series. But for now, I'm gonna first do Portal and then Portal 2. So, Portal is a really... it's a really famous puzzle game. If you haven't heard it by now, well, you should have. You've missed out a lot. Especially Portal 2 is much better. But you're gonna see, just like with Half-Life 1 and Half-Life 2, how do things come from the first game to the second game, and thus you can follow the storyline. Because when I used to watch a lot of YouTube videos regarding video games, I really like to follow the storyline, because that's what interests me. Like, for example, Mass Effect. I never liked games in the style of Mass Effect, but I really did like the story. So I just watched and looked at how the story goes. So let's go straight into it. We're gonna play through the intro. Oh, my mouse is kind of fast. I'm gonna lower it. Trip. Oh man. Oh shit, it's so fast. Yes, slow it fast again. I'm gonna lower it a little bit, even more. That should be good. Yeah, this is great.
Hello, and again, welcome to the Aperture Science Computer Aided Enrichment Center. We hope your brief detention in the relaxation vault has been a pleasant one. Your specimen has been processed, and we are now ready to begin the test proper. Before we start, however, keep in mind that although fun and learning are the primary goals of all Enrichment Center activities, serious injuries may occur for your own safety and the safety of others. Please refrain from...
that can't be good.
Turn back. The portal will open in 3.
Dino test sequence.
2. 1.
I can't believe I just touched that. I touched it in myself. My head is so good. Oh wait. This is us. So if you're not familiar with Portal, well, you make portals and you go in portals and you have fun. If I step off this button, I can go in the door. So what I do, take the box, put it there.
Excellent.
Unbox
the cube.
Please
proceed into the chamber lock after completing each test. First, however, note the incandescent particle field across the exit.
Yeah.
This Aperture Science Material Emancipation Grill will vaporize any unauthorized equipment that passes through it. For instance, the Aperture Science Weighted Storage Cube.
Oh, Reparino Cube. So I think this is gonna be a really fast series for me, because I've played it a lot. Not a lot, but I kinda already know the puzzles, so it's yeah. It's gonna be fast, probably. Let's see, this is gonna be number 2. Oh, number 1, never mind. Number 1? What does number 1 have? I guess nothing.
Please place the weighted storage cube on the 1500 megawatt Aperture Science Heavy Duty Super Colliding Super Button.
There's the cube. You wait for the pulse, you take the cube. You wait for the next one.
Perfect.
Next
please
portal
move quickly to
is
the chamber
at the door.
As the effects of prolonged exposure to the button are not part of this test.
Okay. Now the one speaking is GLaDOS, which is a computer, and we're gonna have a really nice time with GLaDOS, or GLaDOS. So Portal is a game that relies on puzzles. Like, there's no real action, just puzzles, and through solving them puzzles.
You're doing very well.
Thanks.
Please be advised that a noticeable taste of blood is not part of any test protocol, but is an unintended side effect of the Aperture Science Material Emancipation Grip, which may, in semi-rare cases, emancipate dental fillings, crowns, tooth enamel, and teeth.
My, not the teeth. I got it.
Very good. You are now in possession of the Aperture Science handheld portal device. With it, you can create your own portals. These intradimensional gates have proven to be completely safe. The device, however, has not. Do not touch the operational end of the device.
I can't touch
it. Do not look directly at the operational end of the device. Do not submerge the device in liquid, even partially. Most importantly, under no circumstances should you...
Alright. Oh, goddammit. But I can go back from here. So, Poro relies heavily on puzzles, and if you can solve the puzzles, you win the game. That's about it. It requires you to think fast, move fast, and act fast in general. And... well, fast thinker beats the game easily.
Please proceed to the chamber lock. Mind the gap. To ensure the safe performance of all authorized activities, do not destroy vital testing apparatus.
I don't like your cameras.
For your own safety, do not destroy vital testing apparatus.
Oh, I forgot.
Well done. Remember, the Aperture Science Bring Your Daughter to Work Day is the perfect time to have her tested.
Please don't kill it. Dead. That's a radio dead. Sadly. So at the beginning, all the tests are gonna be really easy to pass. As time moves on, they're gonna get a little bit harder, but at the same time, I already know how to solve them.
Welcome to test chamber 4. You're doing quite well. Once again, excellent work. As part of a required test protocol, we will not monitor the next test chamber. Uh-huh. You will be entirely on your own. Good luck.
Okay. I didn't feel the presence of these cameras either way. They just tracked me, but I killed them either way. Because why not? Right. Number 5. Okay, a cube can follow my head.
Certain objects may be vital to your success. Do not destroy testing apparatus.
Okay, I understand. Now I go there. I drop the guy. Maybe he falls on here. And this guy's here. Easy.
As part of a required test protocol, our previous statement suggesting that we would not monitor this chamber was an outright fabrication. Good job. As part of a required test protocol, we will stop enhancing the truth in 3, 2, 1.
Oh, I don't think you ever spoke the truth, but hi. If you ever did, thank you. So you're saying this is gonna go super fast. I really know all the tests already. So over here, you got this little guy. Wait.
While safety is one of many enrichment center goals, the Aperture Science high energy pellet seen to the left of the chamber can and has caused permanent unbelievable. You.
Subject name here.
Must be the pride of.
Subject PomPa here.
More likely yes than no. So these balls, they kill you in one hit, so don't get in their way. use portals or block them with cubes or... yeah, it's a cube anyway.
Warning devices are required on all mobile equipment. However, alarms and flashing hazard lights have been found to agitate the high energy pellet and have therefore been disabled for your safety. Good. Now use the Aperture Science unstationary scaffold to reach the chamber lock.
Easy peasy. Like you can see, they're really easy to solve, especially the early ones. Now, when you get to the portal, do where there, the puzzles are much more challenging. Like they're still easy, but you need to think about it. And I said, you see, well, that's a quite an easy solution. It's still challenging. That's
please
the
note that we have added a consequence for failure. Any contact with the chamber floor will result in an unsatisfactory mark on your official testing record, followed by death. Good luck.
I don't like dying. So the way you solve this guy... wait a second. So, this thing is gonna shoot over there. Like this. Now we're here. Oh, I missed it. Oh, what? Oops. Where does it have to go? Over here. That's the blue up, goddammit. Okay, so it's gonna go through that portal, gonna get come out here. Then we're gonna do this. I was gonna go down here. Radio. No!
Very impressive. Please note that any appearance of danger is merely a device to enhance your testing experience.
Uh-huh. Well, if I fall on that liquid down there, I was gonna die. So yeah, maybe it helps. Maybe not.
The Enrichment Center regrets to inform you that this next test is impossible. Make no attempt to solve it.
Fizz. The cube's dead. That's actually pretty easy. Just need to do that. No, you do this. Then you do that.
The Enrichment Center apologizes for this clearly broken test chamber.
It's not broken.
Fantastic. You remain resolute and resourceful in an atmosphere of extreme pessimism.
I want to get the radio. Well, maybe if I do it like that. God damn it. I want the radio. Yes! How did this work? What the hell? Okay. Alright, let's go. Radio? What? What? Oh man. This is not good. This is not good. Just so I don't kill it, I guess. That sounded not good at all. Like an alarm or something like that. Warning. Radius should work. Perfectly. Not like that one.
Hello again. To reiterate, previous momentum.
Alright. That's easy. So now this guy's gonna go up. Yeah. And we just do like this.
Spectacular. You appear to understand how a portal affects forward momentum, or to be more precise, how it does not.
Okay. Oh, oops.
Momentum, a function of mass and velocity, is conserved between portals. In layman's terms, speedy thing goes in, speedy thing comes out.
Okay, so we go here. We just gotta hit the portal. Wait, what? Oh, I gotta go there. Never mind. Don't mind me. I see, it's pretty easy. You just try to get as much speed as you can. So, you know, just like in Counter-Strike and in Half-Life, when you fall down, you gain up, you gain a lot of speed. And, well, the falling speed gives you the speed the fastest. So, if you can fall down a lot, you're gonna have a great chance to
go forward. The Enrichment Center promises to always provide a safe testing environment. In dangerous testing environments, the Enrichment Center promises to always provide useful advice. For instance, the floor here will kill you. Try to avoid it.
Alright. That sounds really good. What do you do? Oh, you open there. Right. So I know what to do. It's pretty easy. You just gotta go over there. So we're here. And you just gotta hope. And it hits. We're that good. Oh, god damn it. You took my elevator. Okay, I made it. Dodgy dodge.
The device has been modified so that it can now manufacture two linked portals at once. As part of an optional test protocol, we are pleased to present an amusing fact. The device is now more valuable than the organs and combined incomes of everyone in.
Oh, that's really nice. Thanks for letting me know that I'm so valuable for you. Can you go slower, gang? So as you see, now I got two portals that I can control. And technically what I can do is I can just do this. And it's falling down. Or maybe not if I fuck it up. But I can do it like this. And I'm gonna step aside. Okay, I can place everything whatever I want, and I can go in however and whenever, and yeah. It does allow a lot of creativity. There is also a test chamber creating, like it's like if you create the map for CS 1.6, but you create it for Portal 2 instead.
Get ready to fling yourself. Fling into space.
Yeah, I flinged. Thanks. I need a cube. Cube's up there. So I got blue down there. I need orange here. I fly. Where's the... Oh, man. No. It shouldn't fall on top of me. Alright, so let's go get... Oh, I missed. Again, not good. If it's... Just like if it would be breaking the facility. For some reason. See, a little bit of backstory. Aperture Science... Aperture Laboratories and Black Mesa from Half-Life 1. They are competitors, so they're both towards science, obviously, but they're not in the same... They don't like each other.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time.
Why?
If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
So, yeah, button's over there, but I'm gonna cheat a little bit. I'm gonna take this cube. So, as you see, now I got a cube here, just like that. Radio! Alright, so what I'm gonna do... So, I was supposed to do it like that. No.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
It's not that vital anymore. I wanna grab it. What? No! I got it! Okay, it's up there, it's safe. Now, what I need is... Gotta take that. Put it over there. I gotta take the elevator. Wait. Oh, I went there for the cube. Up. Okay, yeah. I went there for the cube and I didn't grab the cube. Done. Now get back in the elevator and get. I have some from the radio.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
Did I push it down? No. Okay, wait.
As part of a previously mentioned required test protocol, we can no longer lie to you. When the testing is over, you will be missed.
Okay. Wait, I should try it. Oh no, I can't change the radio. It's like, normal radio, you can change the station. So you can listen to another one, for example. You can listen to rock, you can listen to pop, or whatever. And here you can't, because obviously you press C, and by pressing E you gotta be... Ooh, I know this one. This... You can solve this test
in two ways. All subjects intending to handle high-energy gamma-leaking portal technology must be informed that they may be informed of applicable regulatory compliance issues. No further compliance information is required or will be provided, and you are an excellent test subject.
You can solve this two ways. You could do it like this. Or you can do it the proper way, or the way it was supposed to be passed. But I don't remember doing it that much, actually. But so the way I remember doing this is like this. It's doing the same thing, but over here. I managed to get up there as well. So I got the cube. Everything's okay. Now I gotta press the cube over there, put the cube over there, rather. And I got a portal up there. So it's the orange one and I got the blue one. I gotta use the blue one. Oh, that's good, right? Please come up, thank you. I'm gonna go up here. And now it's solved.
Very, very good. A complimentary victory lift has been activated in the main chamber.
A victory lift. That sounds really nice. How can you even complain about it? They even put lifts for you, so you... It's like having someone who just comes in every time you do something, and he helps you out any way he can. If you were a famous person, like a VIP, and you just got someone coming after you, helping every way he can.
The Enrichment Center is committed to the well-being of all participants. Cake and grief counseling will be available at the conclusion of the test. Thank you for helping us help you help us all.
So I can't put any portals over there, so what I gotta do is I gotta do this. This. Just a second. And we're out.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
Correct.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
Are there any over there? Okay, no. So this is pretty easy. You gotta do... Okay, one portal there, one portal there. One there. Easy. Alright. Now this could be a little bit more complicated because I can't put any portals here, but I can put some over there. Yeah, we got the same thing. Now we gotta use these stairs to come up here. And jump. Oh, yeah, we got the wrong portal. So I gotta use the blue one over there. And use the blue one again over there. So you just gotta hit the timing. This one. Oh, wow, that's cheating. Come on, game. And I'm here. Cameras? No, sadly. Now, you need a portal here and a portal there. And it's gonna solve itself. Just like that. Oh, whoops. Then you pass it right here. Now we... Oh. Bye-bye, elevator. Now, this elevator here... It goes... backward, basically. So, as you see, it goes towards this side. And that doesn't make it good for us. Like, it's not a nice elevator. It just does that. I got a blue portal over here. And I don't really want a blue one. Wait. Yeah, it kinda screwed up. Kinda didn't. So everything's alright.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
Any more of them vital testing apparatus by chance? Right, so now you got the first timing puzzle in this game. And I think after this one I'm gonna end the video, cause yeah, I think it's not that interesting solving these simple tests in general. So this test also has two ways to be solved. I'm gonna show them. One is this, going up there, and then just jumping down there. And you just gotta hit it. You get enough height and you can do it. And the other one is you gotta use the timing. You gotta have a portal there and a portal over here. So now you create the other one right here. What you gotta do is you gotta press this one, then press this one, then do like this, and there.
Bam. Did you know you can donate one or all of your vital organs to the Aperture Science Self-Esteem Fund for Girls? It's true.
Well, why would I want to do that? Radio! Wait, there is probably a possibility that I can go in here, but I'd be trapped. I wouldn't be able to move out. Alright. Let's go. This one too fast. I might do just one more. But I just really want to wait and get to Portal 2. Portal 1 is going to go really fast, as I said. I'm going to do things really fast. Let's see what this test
is. Due to mandatory scheduled maintenance, the appropriate chamber for this testing sequence is currently unavailable. It has been replaced with a live fire
core
for military androids. The Enrichment Center apologizes for the inconvenience and wishes you the best of luck.
Alright, so we're gonna get to the interesting part. So, just kill this guy.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
Get wrecked. So, I'm gonna end the video here, and the next one we're gonna fight the turrets. They're pretty fun to kill. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.